with either chick.
All right, so it's a 1-1. Unfortunately, we're just they're just two of us. But you know what? What's a better tandem to give you the action for the grand finals? It's nothing less than Manjin Buu, but now speaking in English. Manjin Buu tandem for you. Take it away.
Hello.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Wolf and Yuko. This is it. The Realme Gaming League Grand Finals. Played between Aether Chicks versus Next Play Predator. And we are your casters. I am Shinbu with the One for Ana with my partner.
Manjin Paldas, and we are the Manjin Buu tandem.
In English, in 1 a.m. 1 a.m. edition.
1 a.m. edition. It is an honor.
It is an honor.
It's early. I will now tell everyone that it is an honor to be casting again to the newest game. Yes. Newest game every month. Mobile Legends, ladies and gentlemen. Next Play Predator, yes, versus Aether Chicks, man. They're just kidding with themselves right now. Both of these guys are part of the Aether clan.
Yes, under the same organization. Yeah.
Under the same organization, and they're battling for not just the prize pool, but for bragging rights.
For bragging rights.
Yes, inside their boot camp. Yeah. There you go.
So I'd be expecting a more intense match between these two teams, because they're quite confident, right? They've been together. They're within the team, and you know how friends play with each other. When friends play together, they're out there to crush each other. Right?
They want
to crush each other. No holds barred.
Yeah.
That's what I can totally relate with that one. Speaking of that one, we got Yaoi also going for the jump. That would give the second kill for the members of Next Play Predator Solid, clipping down Togo on that Akai.
Yeah, speaking of crushing, man, that is just a Yaoi crushing the Akai onto the ground. And it's now 1-2. Yeah, I think in terms of score here, Next Play Predator, they're leading by a lot. Because the Aether Chicks team is the secondary team for
So,
in terms of confidence, I think Next Play Predator, they got this one. Like, they're so confident enough that they can beat this team. Remember that yesterday, they actually went on a 2-0 against Aether Chicks, and they let Aether Chicks climb up the lower bracket. But then again, they're the better team against Team Sinag. So now, going back to the game, man, it's 2-3 and nothing's really happening. It's just both of them funneling their main course, the Harriet and the Ling.
Well, they're trying to at least get a scout against the enemy team of how they will counter each other's funnel, especially that we are now to the second rotation of our purple buff. In the middle would be of MM gets the backup from The Last Insanity of Virus. Of course, Blade Tempest coming in from Gymnast as H2O puts the backup. Still, no Zaman Force to be activated. It is going to be the five-man Dark Knight Falls of that Hellcurt down the bottom lane as he tries to mislead that Thams chasing him down.
Wow, this is what would you expect in this type of game, a bloodbath, by friends, sure bloodbath.
Yeah,
both of them respecting each other. I like the decision making coming in from Next Play Predator Solid, respecting the damage of Aether Chicks, disengaging and getting their own serpent. Again, man, the only difference here for the Ling and the Harit depends so much on the blue.
On
the purple,
the Ling
as
well. Yeah, on the Ling as well. But it's heavier on the side of the Harit, indeed.
Definitely.
On the purple vibe.
So if you shut down H2O with the purple, I think Team Aether Chicks will get this one. But meanwhile, there you go. There is a lockdown onto the virus.
And no more escape for Virus here. Of course, Gymnast tries to greet the two man members here of NXP, Yaoi and MB, with his Blade of Tempest. Still not gonna be enough on the damage scaling here for that Ling, is not yet on the point to make that outplay for two members. And that was a nice catch there, not in by Yaoi, as he was able to get a crush onto Virus despite having Virus to burn his last insanity to escape.
You know what, Shinbu? I would just want to commend both of these teams in just, you know what, these are the type of teams that they know when to kill and how to kill it by just basing on the HP bars of their enemies. Of I call it street smarts in the game. the street sense. You know what, you cannot teach those kinds of moves, especially what MB did. on look at this. Even MM manning up to Chester. This is what you don't. This is the moves that you can't teach ordinary players, right?
It's very difficult. Yeah. You only learn it as you play. There is no other way. Virus on round two, ladies and gentlemen. Members here of NXP is out to destroy the virus. As you can actually see that. H2 is just chill on doing his own farm. He is scaling indeed for the most part, though it is MB that has been making big plays along with Yaoi. But H2O also gets a proper scaling for this game. Has the nice KD actually of 2-0-1.
Yeah. Actually, you will understand why they picked up the Harit, because if the Harit gets the advantage against the Ling, the Harit can catch the Steel Tempest under the Zaman Force. So he is going to be confident enough, especially with the Mystery Shop in his emblem. Look at this, a quick Calamity Reaper in his hands. If I'm not mistaken, he also completed his cooldown reduction boots. There you go. Plus that jungle item. So this is looking like a very dangerous Harit here. Yeah, and Timnes is running for his life. There you go.
Yep. Okay, so we get the Ling here getting cornered heavily by the heavy engage as well from the members of Next Play Predator Solid. No backup actually for Timnes on that part. But of course, members here of 806 has been busy pulling up the battle against that Jawhead. And look at that. Another one is dead. It would be of that export. Onto the top lane side, rather. Yaoi was able to get the pin down against that Cho. And another fight breaks out here for the bottom lane. Chester along with Daryl, but of course, Soul of Love is available for Daryl. So, but there's a lot of durability coming in from Chester, and I think Daryl has no idea who can back up with Chester anyway.
And that is the slow, the frigid breath from the Atlas. Can he get this? No, it's not gonna be enough. There you go. Yeah. That is counter go, counter kill. Yeah. The TP is also coming in for Virus. But Renny J is here for the backup.
He went for the flicker, but I think he actually bumped onto Togo and accidentally casted the Cash of Lip onto Togo.
I think he did that on purpose. Because you know what? Renny J is one of the players who just go in very aggressive, always want to do the high-risk plays, and he knows. He actually calculated that. Earlier. Well, by the way, H2O, a little bit of bloopers.
Yeah.
In a game, but yeah.
Bump on the wall on that part, along with the Cyclone Eye. Renji here getting torched back. Ironically, this is the Tamus getting toasted here along with the fire of Virus, but that leaves some freedom for the members of NXP to take up the position here onto the purple serpent. That is MM gets the knockout against Yaoi, now channeling his jump.
There you go. That is the jump from the squid. Instead of Yaoi jumping, the Atlas. Chester jumped. Well, by the way, Shinbu, what's happening right now is they're suppressing Gymnast right now to farm up items. And again, without any form of guilt for the side of Gymnast, the Harit can outplay him. Again, the scaling, you don't want to fight under the Zaman Force and H2O, he's now unfazed.
Yeah.
With this type of stat that they have.
I just want to mention, Harit greatly requires that purple buff, but also benefits greatly on the Soul of Lava.
Yeah.
The Soul of Lava, and it's always present here on the H2O look at the burst.
There you go.
Went in for the Zaman Force as he knows no more Firaga armor is on that X-Borg. No fire will stop H2O from advancing. But there's going to be the split with the Cho and along with the Hellcurt up top. Let's see what will be the setup as well by the Akai. And look at that, Crypt is also coming in from MB's side, huh?
We shall see, because for team Aether Chicks, they're trying to do something here in the top side. Yeah. Trying to force Next Play Predator to react. But, man, they don't care in the world. What they want to do is to give H2O the space that he needs, and H2O can outplay everyone. Yeah. I think this is a pre-turtle for the taking, Shinbu. I don't know. Actually, I don't know what's the plan for the side of Aether Chicks.
It is actually difficult for the side of Aether Chicks. There is a requirement for pickups for them using that Elkert, using Togo on that Akai, but they cannot take a full fight here. And the problem is there is a lot of pickup capacity on the edge here of H2O along with Chester. All you need to do is just get the vision down using that squid on Chester's side. You cannot even burn. You cannot even burn that Dark Knight Falls just so you can escape the advance of H2O and Chester. Even Togo here, he's checking anymore into the mid lane side. Things are looking difficult now for Aether Chicks.
The Calamari is doing it. There you go. Zamforce through the Fatal Lich. Plus the Steel Tempest to counter go, but it's not going to be enough because Daryl and Gymnast now running for their lives. We're now at the third tower, guys.
Yes, we are now at the third tower. And this is starting to become a one-sided game. Good.
Dude, bro, Parakoy, actually, Angie, what? H2O received 4 hits under the turret. And look at his health bar. All of that mitigated by the shield. Every time he dashes, he gets the shield. Yeah. That's Knight of the Turret. Look at the damage of the turret.
Wow.
One shield up under the Zaman Force, and yep. 2 hits under the turret. Even H2O can just do the tower dives alone. He just needs to be careful and wary of that crowd control. But he got the purification on. So,
yeah.
Really, H2O has been snowballed out of hand. Yeah. Out of hand. Like, 803 on that turret.
You know what? His HP bar is I think his HP bar has taken some glutathione because it's all white.
All white.
It's all white, man.
Nomad Peach wants it.
Yeah, this is how the H2O plays, actually. If you funnel him up, he's a one lean, mean, green player who can really play mechanical heroes such as the Claude, the Ling, and the Harriet. So right now, like what you've said, man, I think for Team Aether Chicks, what they need to do is to just be steady, be patient, and wait for pickoffs. But I think you cannot do this.
Very difficult. Yeah, it's very difficult. Because you know why? You want the pickoffs, and it's H2O in the front line. He's actually beating up a lot of pickoffs there. There's even no heavy requirement for Yaoi to hard him because H2O, along with Chester, has been putting themselves into the front line. It's like you're playing Game of the Generals and you have your flag on the first of the board.
And if you're gonna think about it, the Akai and the X-Board, they actually counter this Harit, but H2O doesn't care anymore, right? Because the Akai can go for the Hurricane Dance, push the Harit out of the Zaman Force.
Yeah.
The X-Board can pull off his Fire Stakes, probably reposition the Harit or reposition him up and go for the last Insanity. But again, it's H2O getting all the buffs in the world, getting all the kills in the world. It's the H2O show now.
It's totally difficult as well because the Ling has been disregarded already. I think H2O can develop the Ling. Here you go. You got a 2v1 situation as H2O tries to chase down the Hellcat up the bottom lane. But of course, Dark Knight Pulse has been activated. H2O has no idea that Ling is just around the bottom lane corner. Of course, Dark Knight Pulse already expired. That gives freedom for Gymnast to recall. The third is base, but get the Lord already knocking into the base as well of Aether Chicks. That's a lot of damage. Tons of damage coming in from H2O. Zaman first activated as left. The Fatal Links come in from Chester. It doesn't matter as this is a message to come in as well. NXP, ladies and gentlemen, going into the base here of Aether Chicks. That's how it's done. I think this is the game for itself. Another Fatal Links. Links Rauto, maybe the Ejector. All you need to do is just go for the base. There are a lot of minions, ladies and gentlemen.
Hold up
for the case of RPH and hold up this game one. I could dare say easily goes to next play Predator Solid.
Wow. Wow, that's a solid performance. They're not the main team for nothing. And there you go. Game number one, I think. Both of these guys, they know each other pretty well. It went to the point, you're Manjin as well. It went to the point that Team Next Wave Predator Solid, they know when to shut down the Ling pick. They know how to react to the Ling. Yeah. And besides the fact that Team Aether Chicks, they actually countered the Harriet, and the Harriet doesn't care in the world. For Team Next Wave Predator Solid, they have a lot of CCs too.